जय हिंद एवरीवन, इट्स मी शालिनी श्रीवास्तव। लेट अस रिवाइज योर फर्स्ट चैप्टर ग्लोब एंड मैप्स। लेट अस रिवाइज योर फर्स्ट चैप्टर ग्लोब एंड मैप्स। इन एंशियंट टाइम पीपल बिलीव्ड दैट द अर्थ वॉज फ्लैट एंड दे वुड फॉल ऑफ फ्रॉम इट्स सरफेस इफ दे ट्रैवल टू इट्स एज। मीन्स long years ago ancient time people think that earth is a flat surface they will fall from this corner when they go in the last of this earth in around 500 BCE before Christ era a Greek scholar Pythagoras proposed that the earth is round. Pythagoras said that the earth shape is round. In the modern era, satellite images of the earth also proved that the shape of the earth is like an orange or sphere. Means these days satellite images also send the earth shape, and this proved that the shape of the earth is like an orange or spherical shape. We can comprehend the shape of the earth with the help of a globe. We can understand exact shape of the earth with the help of globe. Globe is a exact model of the earth. Okay, now we are going to learn about globe. Globe is a model of earth which gives us a fairly accurate idea about it. On a globe we can see the shape and location of the continents, oceans and seas. Globe is a exact model of the earth. We can see the shape, locations of the continent, seas and oceans. We can only see the half of the globe at a time. We have to rotate the globe to see the other half. A globe is useful mainly to learn the features of the earth. Means we can only see the half of the earth at a time. When we want to see the other half of the globe, we have to rotate it. A globe is useful mainly to learn the features of the earth. Only features of the earth can be shown on the globe. It has its own limitations. Some limits are also on the globe. A globe does not give detailed information. Globe cannot give detailed information of a specific area. A globe is difficult to carry because it occupies a lot of space and it heavy. Globe is difficult to carry everywhere. You can't carry it because it is heavy also and occupies area. A specific area cannot be enlarged on a globe. A small specific area you cannot see large on a globe. Now let us see a globe. This is a globe, exact model of the earth. It is the spherical shape and just show exact shape of the earth. It at a one time we can see only half part of this globe. When we want to see another half, we have to rotate it. Two points are given here, here and here. This is the axis of the earth on which this earth rotate. Globe is the exact model of the earth. Now it is clear. It is a globe, exact shape of the earth. Now we are going to study about maps. A map is a two-dimensional representation of the earth on a flat surface. We can draw maps of continent, countries, state, cities and neighborhood. We can get more detail and specific information through maps. On a map, we can draw on a flat surface and we can draw map of continent, country, city and neighborhood. And we can get more detail and specific information through map. We can show any small area in large way on the map. Even the smallest area can be enlarged and show on a map. We can draw a map to indicate mountain, river, population, crops, wildlife, forest and minerals. A map has its own limitations. We can draw maps to indicate the mountains, rivers, population of any area, crops, wildlife, forest and minerals also. Specific space minerals and rivers, population and crops grown also we can show on a map. A map has its own limitation. Map also have its limitation. The Earth's spherical shape cannot be shown accurately on a flat surface. Map cannot show the exact shape of the Earth because it's done on a flat surface and most distort the shape and size of the landform. Map distort the shape and size of the landform. On the map, we cannot show the exact shape and size of the continent, land or any landform. Okay. Now, it is a map. You can see it is a map and it is drawn on a flat surface. It is India's map only. And it shows different states in different color. You can identify different state on its color on this map and different continent, oceans and different small areas also can be shown in large size in a map and you can identify any area on the map. Okay, now it's completed its map and after that we are going to learn about language of a map. To understand the information given on a map, we use a variety of signs, symbols and colors. These are called the language of a map. When we draw map, we use some symbols and signs and colors on the map to understand that particular area. These indications are called language of the map. Here some symbols are given. You can see that symbols, international and state, district, metalled, unmetalled, monuments, bridge, stream, dam, and well and tank. These symbols are used for these objects and the railway, fort, temple, church, mosque, pasteland, forest, post office, bank, telegraph office, police station. These are have different symbols to show on the map. These are the language of the map and these are the symbols of the map which generally used on the map. Okay, now start atlas. A book of map is called an atlas. An atlas contains many maps in it. A book of map is called an atlas. It contains a large variety of maps such as physical map. It shows physical features of the region like mountain, river, etc. Political map. It shows the borders of different countries and states. It's called political map. And thematic map. Thematic map, it shows the theme such as the network of roads in a city or a country. Atlas, a book of a map called Atlas. It contains many type of maps like physical map. It shows features, region like mountains, rivers. And political map, it shows border of different countries and state. And thematic map, it shows theme such as the network of roads in a city or a country. We also use the other maps like those the depict of the network of railways and airways. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.